Greetings and welcome, good people of YouTube. This is Emmanuel A. Mateo Morales coming to you from my house in Jacksonville, Florida, to bring you part 28 of my playthrough as the Flash through Skyrim's main questline. When we last left off, we had just gotten to the base of the Throat of the World, you know, High Hrothgar and all that stuff. And now we are going to ascend and to hopefully, you know, at least get to the top before we do our epic awesome training with the Greybeards to become even more obscenely powerful. So, yeah, let me just load the game here. Oh boy, a lot has happened, people. A lot has happened since I, uploaded this last video. For one, I finally got caught up with my work, so that's cool. All my work is now caught up, so now I just have to stress about, like, keeping it caught up. You know, I'm not behind anymore, but I have to worry about, like, never getting behind again, you know? So, yeah. The bear... Where'd that bear go? Like at the end of the video, or last video, there was a bear who took out this goat, but, yeah. Oh, yeah, my, I forgot my carry weight is, okay, there he is! There's old, what's his face? Ah, nope, no damage. What kind of soldiers do we have? Oh, there's a, I'm trying to think of a demeaning name from, God, there's this bear. There's this bear that was made by Hanna-Barbera and Filmation and all that. Yogi! Yeah, there's Yogi. There's old Yogi. And his buddy, whose name I forgot. Whatever. I'll think about it after I, steal his immortal soul. Assuming I have a common soul gem. And it does not look like I have a common soul gem. So, whatever. I'll just punch him. One punch! And he's dead. He is deader than Disco. And deader than the series he comes from. But I'll take his bear claws, though, because bear claws are very useful for potions. As we saw in that episode where I got my potion-making skills. My alchemy to level 100 in one go. So, yeah. I'm just adjusting the mic here just to make sure my voice is nice and clear. And, okay. I'm going to assume it is. So, wait. Just... it doesn't feel right, you know? Okay, there we go, okay, let's go. Let's climb up the 7,000 steps, and, you know, finally kick the main quest line into high gear, you know? Because, well, as fun as this playthrough has been, believe me, it's been a ton of fun, and it's, as fun as this playthrough has been, and believe me, it's been a ton of fun, especially now that I am, I am become deaf and stuff, you know, but, yeah, the point is, I want to start another playthrough, I want to expand the channel, you know, I want to do some other stuff besides this playthrough, but, you know, since I don't like to do things, unfinished, you know, I'm gonna keep going through with this until, yeah, I'm gonna do everything in the main quest line, pretty much, right? And I'm going to start a new, you know, series. I'm going to keep this character in case I decide to do something new with him, but, I'd like to, you know, hurry up, because I got another superhero that I'd like to do. I think I've said this before. And it's going to be really, really awesome. And I'll give you a hint, he has, let's just say he's a billionaire genius. He's also a philanthropist, but he's not necessarily a playboy, if you catch my meaning. I think I may have spoiled it too much, but, let me just talk to this guy, whoever this guy is. Parkner, oh wow. That's a name. Like when he got popped out of his mother's coochie, or whatever, like, they just decided to, like, saddle him with a name that would forever haunt him. Parkner. I mean, wow, what was their second name? What was going to be his parents' second choice? I don't know, Sniff Buttsnar or something? Or a Wagstailnar? Wolfsnar? I don't know, anyways, I'm running out of material here, running out of ideas, so let's just talk to him.
Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar.
Oh, Wolfnar. Do you visit the Greybeards? Question mark?
They're not the sort to take visitors. But I never go that high up the path anyway.
I only get high in my own house.
Some folk who make the trip leave them food or other essentials. but not to make conversation.
Yeah, I don't really think that, well, the Greybeards, well, even if you could talk to them without them, like, killing you and stuff, I don't think they'd really have much to say. They'd probably have, like, you know, boring old folks saying, like, well, stuff boring old folks would say, like, where's my grandkids? Have you come with my prune juice? Where are my pills? My Viagra? Oh, I can't get it up anymore without the pills and the Viagra and the Puddin' Pops. But, okay, what are you doing? Question mark.
I like to spend time up here. Walk the steps.
Trip on the hose.
On the emblems. Doesn't hurt when I bag some game along the way.
And some bitches, know what I'm saying? Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Did you hear the Greybeards call Dovahkiin? Question mark.
I did. Strange days when the monks will do that. I wonder what it means.
It means Dragonborn. Like, that's what Dovahkiin means. Like, I don't know how you cannot notice. You live in a, like, you know, a place that presumably speaks some form of Nordic, aside from, like, the bastardized Latin that they also probably speak. So I don't know how you don't know what that means. But, yeah, whatever, Barknar. Go bark up a tree, you know? And make sure you bark up, like... Make sure the tree you bark up is not the wrong tree, Barknar. Make sure that it's not the wrong tree. You know what I'm saying? Oh, I hope he knows what I'm saying. Because, you know, those are some awkward situations. Am I right, people? Some very, very awkward situations. I wonder what's up here. Ooh, a moose! Or no, a goat. Hello, ram, whatever, mountain goat, billy goat. Yeah, hello, Billy. Let's see what this etched tablet reads. Well, it says. Let's see what this etched tablet says, because I don't think, you know, it really says much. I mean, I can't see. It's like chicken scratch. Like, it's like in those cartoons, you know, old cartoons, or maybe new ones, where, you know, instead of showing people, the audience, I mean, what characters actually write, they just, like, write a bunch of squiggly lines, and apparently that's supposed to be, you know, handwriting. I remember when I was in kindergarten, I thought that I could actually get away with that, you know, writing scribbly lines instead of actually writing assignments. Because, you know, I saw it on TV, so I thought it had to be true. But, okay, yeah, let's just press E here. Emblem 2. Men were born and spread over the face of Mundus. The dragons presided over the crawling masses. Men were weak then and had no voice. Okay, so they... Well, how were they called men then? Because if they had no voice, how could they, like, speak to each other and call each other men? And apparently that's Tablet 2. Tablet 3 is apparently somewhere down here. Oh, here it is. Yeah, I forgot to read that for some reason. Don't know why. Okay, let's read Tablet... Let's pretend we didn't read Tablet 2 and let's just read Tablet 1 here. Emblem 1. Before the birth of men, the dragons ruled all Mundus. Their word was the voice, and they spoke only for true needs. They spoke only for true needs? What the fuck does that mean? Like, did they speak, like, did they say, me want a doobie if they needed a doobie? I mean, because I understand some people, like, truly need doobies, so, whatever. Okay, let's continue. For the voice could blot out the sky and flood the land. Ooh, I hate when that happens. When that time of the month comes around and, my female peoples get like that, that's just terrible, you know, my female peoples. That's a vague enough term, so, I'll just leave you guys watching at home to figure out what that's supposed to mean. But, yeah, let's just keep going. Oh, my frame rate's actually pretty high, even though my computer's hot as shit today. It's not like at 15 or some shit, you know. I guess it's because I'm not playing with, you know, flash perception or flash super speed on, so, you know, less... stress on my, you know, my system here. Yeah, let's just pretend we did not get to the second, tablet here, and let's pretend we read the first one first, you know. Come on, Billy, get out of my way. Yeah, you guys know what I mean, right? You do? Okay, cool. Let's just keep going. Just keep swimming, just keep swimming, 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 swimming. Oh, God. I'm really sad now, you know? Because, you know, that new Finding Nemo movie, or that new Dorothy movie, if it had come out when I was younger, I'd be so happy, but because, like, it took them this long to make it, you know, and because of everything that's happened, and because of, like, how I've changed, like, you know, I'm not gonna see it. Granted, I haven't been to the theaters, and I think I said this before, I haven't been to the theaters since I saw Age of Ultron, and I'll never go to the theaters again for as long as I live if I can help it, but, yeah, let me just punch out this frost roll. Come on, I'm trying to think of a funny name for these guys. I know, Yetis, Abominables, you know, like Abominable Snowmen, Damn Dirty Apes! That's what we're gonna call them. Come on, you damn dirty ape, you're not gonna do anything to me. I'm the Flash, the fastest man alive, Barry Allen. Also known as Def, the One Punch Man, and, I don't know, the Black Racer. You know, that guy with, you know, the jet ski, or, well, the regular, like, snow skis. Like, he's a new god, created by Jack Kirby, supposed to represent Def. He probably takes inspiration from the Silver Surfer, another Jack Kirby creation. Though, I don't really think I'd make a good Black Racer. I actually think, Zoom, like, the CW series, Zoom, you know, from the CW series, would make a better Black Racer, because he's actually wearing black and stuff, you know? And he's actually kind of, like, dark and mysterious and maybe a little bit evil. I'm not sure if the Black Racer is evil. I think he might actually just be, like, you know, Dev. Like, he comes for everybody, whether they're good or evil, but, yeah, anyways, let me just punch him out. How should I do it, though? Should I power attack him, or should I, you know, get both of my fists out? Should I just one punch him like a regular punch? I'm not sure. Okay, let me just one punch him, just a regular punch. And kablooey. No, wait. Kablooey. Okay, let me see let me just keep punching him. Maybe I'll move forward enough. Okay, I'm not, so, okay, there we go. Come on. Okay, now we're good. He's dead. He is out of here. Troll fat, I'll take that. And I'm too encumbered to run. Shit. Bloody rags. Ooh. Oh, I can make some jokes about bloody rags, but I ain't gonna, you know. That's too low even for me, which is saying something. I'll just drop these pelts, you know. What am I gonna do with them? It's the eyes that are really valuable. Yeah, the saber cat eyes are really valuable because you can make alchemy ingredients with them. And besides, once I decide, I'm not even sure if I'm even going to decide to make I'm not sure I'm going to decide to get my smithing to level 100. I mean, what's the point now? But besides saying I did it and maybe selling some stuff, but maybe I could do it to sell some stuff. But that's gonna come later. That's gonna come later if it comes at all, you know. That's not necessarily, you know, a necessity at this point. Oh, wait, no. Okay, no, I got to go this way. I thought that was another path, but, nope. Turns out I was wrong. Again, that happens sometimes, you know. Okay. Oh, another yogi. This one's white. If only there were polar bears in this game. That'd be so epic if there were polar bears in this game. But unfortunately, they're not. They're just they're just snow bears, whatever that means. Okay. Ooh, berries. Let me take some of those. Okay, let's save right here. And now, just in case, and let's go. I really hope I. Damn it! I should have made a new save. I shouldn't have saved over my previous stuff. So. So now, if things go bad, you know, things go bad, you know. And I won't be able to reload to a previous save. Which is going to, blow really badly, or a whole lot, if I have to, you know. Frost Troll. What's down here? Okay, another. Okay, this is the third one, I believe. Come on, let me get the gold. Come on, okay, there we go. Let me just put this bowl over here where it won't interfere with my OCD that badly, you know. Okay, here's this is the third one, the Emblem 3. The fledgling spirits of men were strong in old times, unafraid to war with dragons and their voices, but the dragons only shouted them down and broke their hearts, and probably their anuses and their penises as well, and probably their coochies as well, you know, who's counting, really, you know? Okay, so that's the third one, and, there's the troll over there. Let me just save again, and make sure to make this one a new save, just in case, you know? Okay, come on, Fido, or... Come on, you damn dirty ape, get down here. What's this? Oh, wait, no, I thought that was something. Nope, just some textured, some oddly textured whatever. There's a cairn right here. Yeah, this is a cairn. A cairn is like a marker. In case anybody doesn't know, allow me to educate you and tell you that a cairn is like a marker. It's made out of, like, rocks and stuff like this, you know? This is a cairn. It's meant to mark stuff. Typically made out of rocks. A bunch of piles of rocks like that. It's not inherently an Eastern European... I mean, an East Asian thing, you know? It's been used for, like, you know, in the West as well, quite often. Okay, so yeah. Not just Eastern European thing. European, blah. But also a, not European, Eastern Asian thing. It's not just an Eastern Asian thing. It's also a, you know, Western thing. Perfectly reasonable. Western thing. I'm gonna go up there just to check it out, you know? Might as well. God, I'm so glad we're like, powerful as crap right now. But now... That's gonna lead to a question, you know? Like, how are we, How are we going to, entertainingly, like, take out our enemies now? That's the question. And I'm wondering if I should get, like, you know... Well... I won't say it, but I'm wondering if I should get a mod to make, unarmed combat more, interesting. I was gonna save it for some other video, but, yeah, I'm not, sure about that as well. I also said I was gonna do something else, right? Did I? So I was gonna get another mod or something, or... Oh, no, I said I was gonna get, like, I don't know, my alchemy, or my smithing. I thought I was gonna get my smithing up or something. Possibly, maybe. But, yeah, whatever. Let me just punch this guy out, because I cannot think straight right now. Let's go with a power attack for this one. And he's dead before he can even strike me. Man, do I have reach or speed even without, you know, flash super speed, I guess. Okay, so this is what he was protecting. There's an iron ore vein. An iron ore vein over here. Okay. Kablooey. Oh, wait, did he take out this? I think he may have taken out that. Whatever that was, a goat. Another billy. Yeah, a billy. Took out a billy. That's what he did. Okay, let me just save here. You know, I really want to know which one of those graybeard motherfuckers thought it was a good idea to, like, build up, like, a temple on, like, a mountain with fucking frost trolls and bears and shit camping out, you know? I mean, yeah, it kind of deters people, or deters, like, you know, robbers, but... Goddamn, man, I mean... Imagine what that guy who, in last episode, we figured out, or we discovered, like, gives these guys food and supplies and stuff. Imagine what he has to go through. Really. And he just said wolves, or, like, just a few wolves and shit. No, there aren't just a few wolves, motherfucker. There are fucking trolls and bears and shit, okay? God, that guy is, like, a motherfucking beast. He has to be a fucking beast. He's also a fucking liar, but it's a good thing we're powerful, you know? Because, like, if we weren't powerful, his lies probably would have caused us to fucking die. You know, but, yeah, let me just, pick up these snow bears. Who's this chick? Karita.
Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar.
Bitch, there are some things... I was just talking about that. There are some shit... There's some shit up here much worse than wolves. They're fucking, you know... Super powerful gorillas... Gorilla-like creatures up here, you know? Damn dirty apes, the trolls, and they're also, like, fucking cave bears, yogis. How the fuck did you get up here? Seriously, because those things would probably ice you at this difficulty. Seriously, are you like one of the Daedric princes in the skies, or you're like one of the nine divine in the skies? What are you? Because like you, just look at you. Look at her. Like look at my cursor. Like she, there's no way she could survive up here. You know, I probably would have died up here if I didn't have like if I wasn't like so OG. You know, but what are you doing? Question mark. That's what I want to know. You know.
Walking the steps, meditating on the emblems. I make this trip every few years.
Oh, few years. Yet I'm pretty sure that we'll be seeing her a whole bunch of times, you know. Just up here if we were to walk here. Like this is her area where she spawns in and stuff. Which is weird. But who are you? Question mark. Seriously, you have to be like one tough mamma jamma to come up here.
Just a pilgrim. I'd prefer to leave it at that, if you don't mind.
She's a witch! Burn the witch! Did you hear the Greybeards call Dovahkiin, which is me, I guess, or whatever? You know, Dragonborn, that kind of shit.
I was just outside Ivarstead when it happened. It's an exciting moment. Nothing like this has happened in centuries.
Well, except for that one time that Martin, you know, closed that ginormous Oblivion Gate in the Imperial City, but you know, what are chances of you know, Oblivion, you know, being any factor in this game at all, you know? Wink, wink. Okay, so she has nothing else to say.
All
Okay.
right then.
Let's just read this fourth one. Okay, yeah, it is Emblem 4. Fire Emblem 4. Fire Emblem 4. Kine or Keen called on Parthenox or Partholomew, Parthenax or whatever, who pitied man. Together, they taught men to use the voice. Then dragon war raged, dragon against tongue. Well, apparently the ancient Nords weren't big on grammar, you know? Like, at all. Because that was some terrible ass grammar. Right there. This is coming from me, so you know just how terrible it is. Oh god, we have so much to go. I can't think we're getting closer though now, I think. Well, here's another cairn. I wonder if there's anything here. Let me just check. You know, let's travel on the path less traveled or whatever, you know. Okay, nothing there. But yeah, I tell you, as much as I'm complaining right now and making fun, High Hrothgar is one of those places, you know, where it can be one of those places where that thing I like to talk about. What's that over there in the distance? Looks like a structure, or maybe something. But yeah, it's one of those places that can really be heartbreakingly beautiful. Like it can make you cry and tear up and feel like a little bitch or a little child. Or a little snot-nosed bitch child, you know? Again, it really is, you know? It's pretty. Like, it's so pretty, it wants to make you cry. Or it makes you cry. I can't believe there's no troll here. You'd think there'd be a troll here. This totally looks like a place a troll would spawn at. In fact, I bet you a troll would spawn at here sometimes, you know? But it just didn't decide today. Maybe because I heard about how OG we totally are, about how much we are Saitama, the One Punch Man, slash Barry Allen, slash The Flash, slash The Fastest Man Alive, but whatever. Let's read Tablet 5. Fire Emblem 5. Man prevailed, shouting Alduin out of the world, proving for all that their voice too was strong, although their sacrifices were manifold. Okay, this one's grammar is better. They're getting better. The ancient Nords got better as they were making these tablets, apparently, I guess. Oh, yep, another fucking damn dirty ape. Okay, we did a power attack, a single power attack. Oh, look, he's jumping. I can jump too. I can act like a monkey too. See, see, monkey, monkey see, monkey do. You know, or hear no evil, see no evil, and speak no evil. But yeah, I think I'm gonna go with the dual wielding power attack here. Bam, bam. Oh, well. Yeah, I forgot. I forgot how OG we are, so, yeah. I forgot how the first punch would have, you know, flattened him like it did with ease and stuff, so, yeah. Okay, he was over here-ish? You know, I don't usually like explore High Hrothgar when I come here. Like usually when I come here, I just want to go straight for the Greybeards, maybe some iron ore veins or veins of other precious material. Like if I was playing this like legit, like you know, just plain vanilla game. But yeah, I'm just gonna save here, I guess. Okay, there's like a big ginormous temple there. Wait, I heard something. I hear something on the wind. It almost sounds like a word wall or something. And it's not just wind. I think I hear a word wall somewhere. I must be going crazy, I guess. Maybe, possibly. Let me see what's up here. Oh no, it's just another like column or whatever. Not a cairn, a column. See, this is a cairn, this thing right here, and this is a column, people. There we go. I'm glad I could educate at least somebody in the audience tonight, or in the morning, or wherever it is where you're watching this at, you know. Whatevs, whatevs. Okay. Alright, another cairn. Oh, I thought there was another damn dirty ape. But no, it was just a cairn. And this, the white snow, I guess, and, you know, this tablet here. Okay, Fire Emblem 6. With roaring tongues, the Sky Children conquer, founding the first empire with sword and voice, whilst the dragons withdrew from this world. Okay. I don't know why the dragons would withdraw from this world, since, you know, everybody in this world right now is, like, fucking scared shitless of them because they kick fucking ass, and, you know, if this was, like, actually happening, you know, they'd burn down every single fucking village because every single fucking village uses wood and stuff, you know, mostly, except for Markarth. Markarth is, you know, since Markarth actually has stone and stuff, since it was actually made out of, It actually used to be like a dwarven village, but yeah, let me just drop this goat cheese wedge here. I'll keep the mammoth cheese though. Oh, nope, still over encumbered. Okay. Let me see what I can drop. Gold ingots, Clemex supplies. Well, Clemex, that sounds like Namek, or Namek, you know, a Kryptonian guy from, you know, DC and Superman and stuff, you know. I think maybe the mad scientist who blew up a moon or something, possibly. But, yeah, let me just... Okay, these are just elven boots. Let's drop these necromancer robes, whatever, you know. We don't need that shit. Okay, there we go. Alright. Ooh, snowberries. Yeah, that's what we need, though, snowberries, because, as we saw, snowberries and butterfly wings, I think, can make enchanting potions, and we may need to make some, enchanting potions again someday, soon, or whatever. You know, in case I want to, like, make more obscenely powerful, you know, items, and, you know, like, get better enchanting, you know, better, like, enchanting gear to start off, you know, better than... You know, well, create enchantments with better fortified potion making or better fortified alchemy. Because you know, how awesome, how much faster would it have been if I were to, like, you know, have like potions that made me like 100% more powerful or some shit like that. You know, how much quicker. You know, Fire Emblem 7, the tongues at Red Mountain went away humbled. Jürgen Windcaller began his 7-year meditation to understand how strong voices could fail. Okay, the tongues at Red Mountain went away humbled. That's probably a reference to Morrowind and to lore. That seems really familiar, but I'm forgetting right now. But I know Red Mountain is a location in Morrowind. It was like, you know, the mountain, a really big, ginormous, active volcano, actually, in it. And a few hundred years before the event of Skyrim, or sometime like that, you know, maybe not a few hundred, but like at least over 100 years ago, at least over 100 years. You know, Red Mountain blew up, and a lot of the Dark Elves had to, like, get out in, like, a diaspora or diaspora or whatever. And that's why a whole lot of them are in, you know, Solstheim and shit. But so, yeah, read Etched Tablet. Emblem 8. Jürgen Windcaller chose silence and returned. The 17 disputants could not shout him down. Jürgen the Calm built his home on the throne of the world. Yes, he built he was so calm, he built a home on one of the most dangerous places in the world. Seriously. How the fuck does that make any sense? I don't know, ladies and gentlemen. Tune in at 11. Derpy derpy derp. Okay. I really do think we're getting closer, though. Or we're getting closer to, like, you know, the first part of it. Like right before... Oh, no! Here we are! Yeah! There we are, yeah. Here's the temple part, you know. Spoiler alert, you know, like, there's more to the mountain, as you can clearly see. But, that's gonna take a while. Okay, that was Fire Emblem 8. This is Fire Emblem 9, right? Yeah, this is Fire Emblem 9. Emblem 9. For years all silent, the Greybeards spoke one name. Tiber Septim, stripling them? Ooh. Oh, stripling. Oh, stripling den. Okay. Tiber Septim, stripling den, was summoned to Hrothgar. They blessed and named him Dovahkiin after, you know, having him clean the latrines and stuff, you know? I like the music right now, though. Oh boy, one of the major set pieces of the game, people. We have finally made it. Well, especially the main storyline, you know. Yeah, we have finally made it. Cool. If only they made, like, you know, I swear to, if only they made, wait, is that coastline, or? Well, maybe, possibly. But I tell you, if only they made, like, you know, superhero mods for, like, Oblivion. I think, actually, I may actually do an Oblivion playthrough, because I also have that game as well. You know, like, a couple years back, my brother or somebody got me, like, you know, the Elder Scrolls Legendary Edition pack that had, like, all five Elder Scrolls games up to that point. And, yeah, I got, like, Oblivion for, like, the 50th time, but don't even get me started on my history of Oblivion and buying multiple versions and shit. Yeah, I actually think I might do a playthrough with, like, a Brotherhood of Steel power armor, because I saw, like, a mod of that, you know? Like, some guy actually got, like, the Brotherhood of Steel power armor from Fallout 3 and was somehow able to reverse engineer it to the more primitive, you know, system of Oblivion, or Gamebryo engine of Oblivion. So, yeah, let me just read the final Etched Tablet. Emblem 10, the voice is worship. Follow the inner path. Speak only in true need. Okay, well, Voice of the Sky added. What the fuck does that do? Animals will neither attack nor flee from you. 23 hours. Huh. 23 hours. Is that, like, in-game time or, real time? Because I forgot about this. I think... I vaguely recall, now that I think about it, now that I've gotten it again, but, yeah. Cool, I guess. I guess this would have been better, you know, when we were actually, like, on the grind for, like, enchanting, because then I wouldn't have I've had to chase animals and shit, but, and the animals also wouldn't have attacked me, so, whatevs, whatevs. I guess it's kind of cool, kind of neat. I totally, absolutely forgot about it, though, before, you know, it happened. Okay, where's the plate, or whatever? Huh! Large sack. I'm not gonna make a joke about that. Ooh, flowers. I'm gonna pick all that for ingredients and shit. Potion of Cure Disease. Okay. Salt pile! That's actually really good. Okay, let me put in my, whatever I had to put in. It wasn't this, it was something else. What was it? Here, this is what it is, I think. Okay. So yeah, I put the supplies in there, and yeah, now I can get something from him, I guess. Maybe some knowledge. Some really powerful hidden knowledge, I guess. Okay, what should I drop? Because I am overweight as shit. Okay, let me drop this shit. Seriously, what the fuck am I gonna do with a hide shield? Really? At this point. Okay, there's another entrance. We're gonna go on the other entrance. I'm not gonna go where the floating arrow tells me to, because I'm a man. I have, you know, I've been endowed by my creator, the god of the universe, to, with free will, so I'm not gonna do what the game wants me to. At least at this point, you know, I'm gonna be my own stallion or my own guy. Oh, fuck. Shit! Oh, fuck. I stole some shit. Let me just reload. I'm gonna be my own man, not stallion. I'm not an animal. I am not an animal. I'm a man, I'm a human being, I'm a person, so yeah. My own dog. I will say my own dog, though, because dogs are cool. Seriously. Fuck horses a lot. Though I guess they're kind of cool sometimes, but dogs are better, you know?
So, a dragonborn appears.
Well, a speedster dragonborn. Yeah, Flashpoint Paradox was full of plot holes and inconsistencies like that, I guess. Arngiar or whatever. You call me Dragonborn. What does that mean, derpy derpy derp? I'm answering your summons. Let me go with this one. You call me Dragonborn. What does that mean? ? Derpy derpy derp.
First, let us see if you truly are Dragonborn. Let us taste of your voice.
I don't swing that way, buddy. Well, you guys... Yeah, I don't swing that way. Yeah, now I know what you monks do up here all the time, and I don't think I'm good. I think I'm gonna... Nah, I'm kidding. Well, only somewhat, but, let me get to my unrelenting force.
Boosh! Shout at us.
Oh, at us.
Taste of your voice.
Okay. Well, Leroy Jenkins! Oh, dang it. I want to do a Leroy Jenkins thing, but, nope. My thing has to regenerate now. At least I know I can find Dragon's Tongue here, which I guess is fitting, you know. It's actually pretty fitting, Dragon's Tongue, and I'm not gonna explain to you why, because if you don't get it, you know, you're kind of a derp, you know.
Will not harm us.
But if it does, we totally will kill you. Like Black Bolt, which is a Marvel character, so I don't know why I'm talking about him. But I guess he was cool before the writers fucked him up and did some horrible horse shit with him. I guess he could be cool again, but whatever. Let me just press this.
Boof! Dragonborn, it is you.
Arngear.
Welcome to High Hrothgar. I am Master Arngear.
Arngear, that's what it is.
For the graveyards. Now, tell me, Dragonborn.
I speak for the trees.
Why have you come here?
Like the Lorax or some shit. I'm answering your summons, Master. I want to find out what it means to be Dragonborn. Who are you? What is this place? Derpy derpy derp. Let's go with this one.
We are here to guide you in that pursuit.
Yes, guide me. Make me more powerful than I already am.
To guide those of the dragon blood.
Make me a Speed Force pagan deity, you heathens. You mean I'm not the only Dragonborn?
You are not the first. There have been many of the dragon blood since Akatosh first bestowed that gift upon mortal kind.
For some reason or another, it's not really clear, I don't think.
That is not ours.
Well, maybe it is. Check it out if I'm wrong. You know, check to see if I'm wrong, people. Do some research.
That is all I can say.
Exercise your God-given brain and stuff. Who are you? What is this place?
We are the Greybeards, followers of the Way of the Voice.
I think I said it before, you jerkface.
You stand in High Hrothgar, the slopes of Kinnereth's sacred mountain. Here we commune with the voice
of the
sky and strive to achieve balance between our inner and outer selves.
As you can see, we have completely and utterly failed. I mean, look at this. This does not look like balance at all. This is too dreary and drabby and dark and shit, so, yeah, I'm answering your summons, Master.
We are honored to welcome a dragonborn to High Hrothgar.
Now bend over.
We will do our best to teach you how to use your gift in fulfillment of your destiny.
What is my destiny?
That is
to bend over.
To discover. We can show you the way, but not your destination.
We can point you like a cannon, but we can't make you fire. You get what I'm saying, son? I guess. I'm ready to learn.
You have shown that you are Dragonborn. You have the inborn gift.
Oh, I have a lot of inborn gifts, buddy.
Do you have the discipline and temper?
I am the Flash. Probably not, but since this is a game, since this is a video game, I guess I do. Yeah, I got a lot of inborn. I got a lot of inborn stuff, buddy. I am the Flash, fastest man alive, Barry Allen, Saitama, the One Punch Man, also deaf.
You shout, you speak in the language of dragons. Thus, your dragon blood gives you an inborn ability to learn words of power.
I know it makes no sense, but we're rolling with it, people.
Three words of power. As you master each word, your shout will become progressively stronger. Master Einarth will now teach you Roll, the second word in Unrelenting Force. Roll means balance in the dragon tongue. Combine it with Fus, force, to focus your thumb more sharply. Roll.
Okay. That makes no sense at all, but whatevs, you know. Okay. This language, this dragon language makes no sense. Oh, that's a word. No. This dragon language makes no sense. It's supposed to be based on the runic alphabet, but the thing is, the runic alphabet wasn't an alphabet. It wasn't a logo syllabic language, you know? Like, in a logo syllabic language, like, those markings would be words, you know? They'd be words, or, you know, they'd also be, like, usually one syllable as well. But, you know, they wouldn't be fucking letters, you know? And then the runic alphabet, you know, didn't, like, the markings there were just letters, they weren't all words, you know? Okay.
Use your unrelenting force shout.
Oh wait, what the fuck? I wanna do that. Targets, what targets? What targets? I forgot about this part. Though now I kinda vaguely remember, like the other part. I guess ghosts? Okay. Okay. So when are we gonna learn Fusro Da? You know, the whole shebang, you know? Okay, I did it.
Well done. Again.
Okay. Oh shit. Alright, hurry up. Hurry up. I don't have all day. You know, just because I'm really quick doesn't mean I have all day, you know? Okay. There he's go. There he's good. Yeah, I thought I did that shit. I thought I pressed Z long enough, you fuck. Okay.
Impressive. Your thumb is precise. You show great promise, Dragonborn.
Okay.
We will perform your next trial in the courtyard. Follow Master Bori.
Master Bori. Oh god, this does not have the setup for exciting times, people. Like at all. At all, I'm telling you. Master Bori. Though, to be fair, I think Tolkien had, like, a dwarf character named Bori in, like, you know, The Hobbit, so... I guess some people can make good with a name like that, though, to be fair, even in Tolkien's case, it didn't work out as well as you would hoped. As well as you would have hoped, you know, but, hey, at least his book was still good, you know? Kind of, dry and hard to get through at times, but... At least it's no Silmarillion, you know? At least it's no Silmarillion. I'll give it that much, you know? At least, you know? Okay.
Master Bori will teach you wool, which means whirlwind.
How the fuck does that work? Okay.
You must hear the word within yourself before you can project it into a thumb.
This is stupid. This is stupid. See, get it? That's a shout. You know, that's a three-word shout of power I just made up. This is stupid. It allows me to beat up stupid people really quickly. If I say it, you know? Okay, let me see here. Where's Whirlwind Sprint? Whirlwind Sprint is right around here-ish, I believe. Okay, let's favorite this shit. Just in case, and let's also equip it.
Master Wolfgar will demonstrate Whirlwind Sprint. Then it will be your turn.
Okay, no, I'm not going to use Whirlwind Sprint. I'm going to use something else.
Master Bori. X.
Wolf.
Now, your turn.
Flash Perception. I do love breaking the game. Okay. Okay. Flash super speed activated. Okay. Come on. And thank you, Speed Force Powers. Ha! It worked! It fucking worked! Oh, I love breaking the game like this. You fucking dumb as shit AIs. Seriously, Bethesda cannot make AI for shit, I'm telling you. Neither can most gaming companies either, but whatever, you know, whatevs.
The mastery of a new Thum is astonishing.
A new Thum I've never seen before.
I've heard the stories of the abilities of Dragonborn, but to see it for myself...
To see them tap into Speed Force by myself, it completely breaks all the lore and the logic of our universe, but, whatever, thank you, what's next? I don't know how I did it, it just happens. I thought it was this easy for everyone. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. I'm such a charmer. Okay, click. There we go.
No, indeed not. But beware that your skill does not outstrip your wisdom.
Whatever, old-timer. Go back to drinking your prune juice, you old fart.
Retrieve the horn of Jürgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ostengraf.
What the fuck would I do that?
Be true to the way of the voice. Will return.
Okay. Hey, I completed the Way of the Voice. Cool. Now I've got the Horn of Jürgen Windballer or whatever. Okay, let's just go through all these questions before we end the video here. Why are the dragons returning? Does that have something to do with me? Could it possibly have something to do with me? Wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
No doubt, the appearance of a dragonborn at this time is not an accident.
Well, at least Arngeir, or whatever his name, realizes, you know. At least he can see that, you know. At least he can, like, read the writing on the wall where that's concerned. You know, he can read the ancient words of power written on the wall, you know, where that's concerned. But, surely there's more you can tell me. Thank you, Master. I'll continue my training. Surely there's more you can tell me. Let's go with that one.
There is indeed much that we know that you do not. That does not mean that you are ready to understand it.
Fuck you, old-timer!
Your easy mastery of the voice tempt you into the arrogance of power. That has been the downfall of many Dragonborn before you.
Just for that, you're going to die. And I'm going to prove just how arrogant I can be. You motherfucking cocksucking... Whatever. Why are dragons returning? Is it... Oh, wait.
No, you should focus on owning your voice, and soon...
Whatever. What does it mean to be dragonborn? Derpy, derpy, derp.
Dragons have the inborn ability to learn and project their voice. Dragons also are able to absorb the power of their slain brethren.
Like a bunch of soul-stealing cannibals, or soul cannibals. Soulables, as I like to call them.
It's been a matter of debate down through the centuries. What you have already learned in a few days took even the most gifted of us years to achieve.
So you have nothing to teach me, is that what you're telling me?
Some believe that Dragonborn are sent into the world by the gods at times of great need. We will speak more of that later, when you are ready.
Okay. Why are shouts in the dragon language?
Dragons have always been able to shout. Language is intrinsic to their very being. There is no difference in the dragon tongue between debating and fighting. Shouting comes as naturally to a dragon as breathing or speaking.
Or shitting or eating.
In times when mortal kind was in great need, the goddess Kinnereth granted us the ability to speak as dragons do. For most people, long years of training are required to learn even the simplest shout.
But I can learn it just because I'm, like, you know, the chosen one, so... I guess I must really piss you old geezers off. Really. God, I wish it pisses you old geezers off. There are only four of you?
Five. Our leader, Parthenax, lives alone on the peak of the throat of the world. When your voice can open the path, you will know you are ready to speak to him.
Oh yeah, and just for, you know... Just to warn you, he's totally not like a dragon or something or whatever. He's totally not a dragon or anything. Though I guess, you know, I actually think those tablets that we read, you know, those fire emblem mark whatever's... I think they spoil too much, actually. Well, they could if you actually look for them. I don't think most players were astute enough for them. But yeah, if you read the tablets, I think it's pretty... It pretty much gives it away. It doesn't just hint. It pretty much gives it away that Parthenox is a dragon, I think. Or something, I guess. You know? Maybe. Well, yeah, but either way, that's foreshadowing. And I kind of like it, but if it gives it too much away, then I'm kind of like on the fence, you know? But when can I meet your leader, Parthenox?
As I said, you will know you are ready when your voice can open the path to him.
Hey, Parthenax, you want some booze? I got, like, you know, a six-pack from, you know, the Kangaroo Express. You know, Heineken, you want some? Okay, he didn't come, or I couldn't get to him, so, tell me about the Greybeards.
We study the way of the voice according to the teachings of our founder,
Jürgen Windballer.
Very few are permitted to study with us here at High Hrothgar.
I don't think people want to come here, buddy. Like, I don't think there's anything about you guys wanting to keep people out. I think people don't want to come here in general. So, yeah. You know. I mean, shit, there are only, like, two fucking people we encountered all the way up here, you know? So, yeah, I really don't think people are dying to get here. Though, if they are dying to get here, they're dying literally. You know what I'm saying? Who was Jürgen Windballer?
He was a great war leader of the ancient Nords. Master of the voice, or tongue.
Or cunnilingus, but,
After the disaster at
that was for completely unrelated reasons.
The Nord army was annihilated. He spent many
years... Oh, that's what... Okay. So that's what that Red Mountain thing meant on that one emblem.
Had punished the
that
Nord
fight at Red Mountain, apparently.
Misuse of the voice. He was the first to understand that the voice should be used solely for the glory and worship of the gods, not the glory of men. Jürgen Windcaller's mastery of the voice eventually overcame all opposition, and the way of the voice was born.
And we have been stuck on this fucking mountain, lonely as shit, ever since. Tell me about the Greybeards.
We study the way of very few, but in your case, Dragonborn, it is a privilege to guide you towards mastery.
Why don't the others talk?
Their voices are too powerful for anyone not...
Oh, so they really are like blackballed for any Marvel fans out there. Though, at least they're not like sexual deviants like he's been made out to be in like the latest comics, but I really don't want to talk about the Inhumans right now. Seriously, fuck the Inhumans. What they've done, what's happened to them. Oh, I miss you, Jack Kirby, and writers from that age. I miss you so much. You truly were the king, Kirby. Truly were. What is the way of the voice? Question mark.
The voice was a gift of the goddess Kinnereth at the dawn of time. She gave mortals the ability to speak as dragons do. Although this gift has often been misused, the only true use of the voice is for the worship and glory of the gods.
Okay.
True mastery of the voice can only be achieved when your inner spirit is in harmony with your outward actions.
So in other words, never.
Contemplation of the sky.
Pretty much for me.
Kinnereth's domain and the practice of the voice, we strive to achieve this balance.
And we never will, because we're a bunch of old geezers who are a bunch of losers as well. I will try to follow the way of the voice. Fuck that shit. But I don't follow your philosophy. Why help me learn the voice? Let's go with this shit.
The Dragonborn is an exception to all the rules. The dragon blood itself is a gift of the gods.
Screw the rules, I have dragon blood.
One gift. How can
Yu-Gi-Oh! Abridged.
As Dragonborn, you have received the ability to shout directly from Akatosh. We therefore seek to guide you on the proper use of your gift, which transcends the restrictions which bind other mortals.
Okay, so this guy... Oh, what is the way of the voice? Did I ask this before?
The voice?
Okay, I think I did.
True,
I think I did, yes.
The contemplation of the sky. Kinnereth's domain.
Okay, whatever, old geezer. Whatever.
We strive to achieve.
Okay, so yeah, that was the Way of the Voice Part 2, you know. Just going to go through this temple here. Whew. Well, that was an interesting episode, I guess. Lots of lore and stuff. Oh, but yeah, you know. I swear, well, definitely, you know, next... Ooh, Hanging Moss. Oh, fuck. Nobody saw that, right? Okay, cool. Cool. Hanging Moss is useful. It's very useful. So, yeah. Well, that was that quest. Yeah, I guess now we have to get to the whatever of Jürgen Windballer or some shit. But we will do that next episode, ladies and gentlemen. So, until next time, this has been Emmanuel A. Mateo Morales signing off. Well, not signing off, but from my house in lovely Jacksonville, Florida, playing as the Flash / Death / Barry Allen / The Fastest Man Alive / Saitama / The One Punch Man. And until next time, peace, love, God bless, all that stuff, and bye-bye.